song that I'm going to share with you tonight is an old hymn, and you're probably all familiar with it. And the first two verses were written by John Gates, who as a young man in his late teens, early 20s, was very gifted in writing. And his mother noticed just something about the talent that God had given him. And so she encouraged him to begin writing poems and ballads and things like that. And so he did. But then in 1897, when he was 54, Ira D. Sankey had gotten a hold of some of his work. And he wrote to him and asked him to become his own personal hymn writer. He absolutely loved the message and the hymns that the poems he was writing and others were studying to music. And so the hymn, Faith is the Victory, was penned specifically for the evangelistic circles where Ira D. Sankey ministered with Dwight Moody. And so he wrote that song, and Ira Sankey personally wrote the melody to it. So the first two verses were penned by John Gates. The third verse that I'll be sharing is one that is very near and dear to my heart. About, probably 30 years ago, I was dealing with a situation where I was very easily offended. And if you've ever been easily offended and you're more withdrawn or reserved, it smolders in your heart. And some of you may or may not know that I'm an identical twin. And my twin sister has the more dominant personality. So in my mid-teens, late teens, we were just dealing with the issues of growing up, but her dominance was really getting to me. And as the more quiet one, I would just let it kind of lay in my heart. And it was like burning embers that were just, it was really getting a hold of me. I knew it was not of God. And I did love the Lord so much. And I asked him, Lord, please help me, because I know that this is hindering, you know, what you want to do in my heart and in my life. And in reading Psalm 119, I came across verse 105 that has been very precious to me ever since. It says, great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. And that word nothing really grabbed my attention. I thought, well, there's not room for anything. You know, if nothing is supposed to offend you, then there's a way to get past this. And I believe the key to that is that we love him. Great peace have they which love thy law. And so I started reading his word from the very the perspective of looking for ways to get past, to grow through this offense that was my besetting sin. And so verse 3 is born from that earnest desire to let him stamp his image deep on my heart, deep enough that when I was rubbed the wrong way by my sister or anybody, that it was his fragrance that would come out and not my offense, my irritation. So verse 3 is based on Psalm 119, 105, and then Isaiah 26, 3, which says, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on me, because he trusted in me. And it's a lifelong process, you know, not perfect. There are still some things that they catch me off guard. But I'm finding you, the more I love him, and the more of his word, that becomes a part of my own heart, and the more he begins to take over in those situations where it does catch me off guard. And you know, the things that, you know, 20, 30 years ago would have gotten the best of me, I can see where he's made a difference in a change. And I'm grateful that we can grow up in him. I'm thankful that he doesn't give up on us, that he's very patient with us, and he loves us too much to leave us where we are. So if you know verses 1 and 2, you're welcome to sing with me. Victory, we know that overcomes. Amazing.